Of course, I thank the organizers for the kind invitation in so beautiful city. I was in 65 the first time in Paris. And so beautiful conference, so beautiful museum, and dinner. This is a research center Enrico Fermi in Rome, and it is in the old Via Panisperna building. So you see the silhouette of the building like it was in the 30s. Now it is quite different. Good. This is a picture of Majorana, well known, because this is the picture is well known, but it is a part of the university booklet, so that you see in context. And you see also that the official name is with I, not with a J. Ettore Majorana, of course, is very well known. His research spans a large spectrum from atomic physics, molecular physics, nuclear physics, and elementary particle physics, even though the activity is very, very short, because as it is very well known, Majorana disappeared at the end of March 38, and the circumstances are considered mysterious by most of the people, but the fact that he disappeared gives a kind of a bias. So there is a strong influence on a distorted view of his overall personality. And in our research, we tried to give a better understanding of the personality. In fact, we written a book and many, many papers on Majorana, and our last expression in this La straordinaria vita di Ettore Majorana, The Extraordinary Life, we see that it is really extraordinary, short but extraordinary. Okay, this is the movie, recent movie, I make advertisement by Egidio Eronico. Now, is this the last paper of Majorana, Teoria simmetrica dell'elettrone e del positrone, Symmetrical Theory of the Electron and the Positron, in published in Nuovo Cimento 5. 5 is important. Remember this number. And here you can see a reprint with a handwritten dedication a Sua Eccellenza Enrico Fermi, con molti cordiali saluti, Ettore Majorana. Sua Eccellenza, His Excellency, because Fermi was a member of Academy of Italy, so by law he had the right to be called Sua Eccellenza, His Excellency. And look also at the date of the reprint, which is also important, and you see April 1st, 37. This is the original reprint, you see the with the typical handwriting of Majorana, and the owner is Giacomo Morpurgo, the physicist involved in the quark model of atoms, and in some circumstances he was able to get this. But we found also one to Giancarlo Vicca and one to Giovanni Gentile Jr. We do not know whether Giulio Racà also received a similar gift. Why the three names? Of course, it is connected with the competition. Now, I will try to describe the genesis of this paper and also give a short notice about the role for the full professorship competition for a chair in theoretical physics at the University of Palermo. So I will try to reconstruct the itinerary. Main points are, as it is well known, strong criticism against the formulation, given the original formulation given by Paul Dirac. And then he was able to establish the unitary infinite dimensional representations of the Lorentz group without negative energy particles. Then there was the discovery of the positron, and you will see that for Majorana it was quite a hit. And then, of course, he knew very well that relativistic quantum wave equation can have the proper physical interpretation only in the frame of quantum field theory, not by themselves. So then he arrived to the establishment of the symmetric theory of electron and positron, and then there is the proposal of Majorana neutrino. It's only one line, one very short line in the paper, then, of course. Now, it is well known that the Majorana contribution of great relevance, not only for the results, but also for the methods. Majorana is strictly Galilean, I would say, so he follows phenomenological methods to establish theoretical schemes, very modern. Now, the treatment, of course, will be very short, but we have some larger paper prepared on the relativistic. Now, the period where Majorana is involved with the relativistic wave equation is quite short, essentially 2 years. Even though the final paper of Majorana appears in 1937, and we will see the strategy which gives this date. Dirac equation, okay, now this is very well known, relativistic generalization of quantum mechanical Schrödinger equation. Of course, the Dirac particle is identified with the electron, right spin, and magnetic momentum. Magnetic momentum is very important. There is a weak point in the theory, but this is at the same time a reason of strength, historically and conceptually. There are negative energy states. And of course, this is a difficulty from a physical point of view. It is very well known how Dirac avoid this. So we have a Dirac C, which is the negative energy states are completely occupied. There can be holes there. And these are, of course, interpreted as positive charge particle. In the initial state, this is very important to understand Majorana. In the initial state, in the initial stage, and for a long period, the positive charge hole is recognized as the proton. Dirac is conservative, of course. And let's read some sentences in this paper, The Theory of Electrons and Protons. You see, a theory of electrons and protons. And it still survives this idea of the proton in the 1931 French edition of his book. And you see here what is written, in particular, take this sentence, we are therefore led to the assumption that the holes in the distribution of negative energy states are the protons. So the holes are the protons. Of course, it is well known that it is impossible. Then, I mean, somebody explained that the hole should have the same mass and so on. So that at the end, clearly there was a hint that there was a new particle. So the theory of the Dirac C has enormous potentialities in the physical interpretation. In a sense, the theory predicts the existence of the positron as it is very well known. Majorana criticism is very, very sharp. And we can follow every step of the criticism. In particular, in this paper, Teoria relativistica di particelle con momento intrinseco arbitrario, which is a 32 paper. About the Dirac equation is as terrible things. Since this equation, I do not read in Italian, applies only to particles with intrinsic momentum 1 alpha, I searched for equations analog to Dirac ones, albeit some more complicated, which allow to consider particles with arbitrary spin, in particular, null. Very, very sharp about the design of the energy. For example, I do not read in Italian, he writes, as a matter of fact, The indeterminacy in the sign of the energy can be avoided by exploiting equations of the basic type only if the wave function has an infinite number of components which cannot be split in finite tensors or spinors. So he exploits infinite component wave equation. There is relativistic invariance in a formulation where there are only positive energy states. These are unitary representation. So there are he writes the expression of the generators. What is published is that is in a particular case where the sum invariant operator, Casimir operator, is zero, but you can immediately find at Domus Galileani in Pisa. There are research nodes where the explicit expressions of the generators are given in the general case. So it's a very important physical result, the representations. Now, the pioneering role is fully recognized in the 1931 paper by Eugene Wigner on Annals of Mathematics. Of course, Wigner builds up all representations through elegant group theory methods. Majorana does it by hands. Here he's able to find the infinite dimensional matrices which represent the generator. But Wigner speaks explicitly of Majorana as a pioneer in the field. Great recognition. He considered this as a preliminary announcement. He wanted to write a more extended paper. Now we have the handwritten manuscript, the original, 11 pages at the Domus Galileani. It's much longer than the published version because there are extensive cancellation and rewriting. And in the parts which have been cancelled, there is also mention about time reversal invariance and so on, which is not preserved in the. To give you a flavor, I mean, Majorana, great inquisitor, so he was very, very sharp. This I say in Italian because it's beautiful. It gives the. Si è perfino tentato, non senza ardimento, di attribuire realtà fisica agli stati negativi, come se la natura fosse in imbarazzo. Per la scelta del segno del radicale, there has been even the attempt, not devoid of temerity, to give a physical reality to negative states, just as the nature would be embarrassed concerning the choice of the sign in the radical. I mean, it's very, very sharp. Now it is possible to follow in complete details the progress for the formulation of the papers, because. There is the paper, there are extensive cancellations. You can find all pieces, you can see what was the preliminary version, what has been published. So this is, for example, the first page is all cancelled. But you can follow word by word what he wrote before and what was cancelled. Extensive paper should appear on Zeitschrift für Physik. In fact, he announces that he will write this paper. For example, I have sent to Zeitschrift, this is a letter for Physik, the paper on the theory of nuclei. This is Heisenberg-Majorana exchange forces. I have ready the manuscript of a new elementary particle theory, which will be sent to the same journal in a few days. So there was the typescript. Now, unfortunately, this paper, fully finished, will never appear. It does not exist among the Majorana material in Pisa. Now, the key point is very, very simple. Until March 1933, Majorana does not believe in the existence of the positron, even though, in fact, he writes a letter to Giovanni Gentile. No, they are electrons going in the opposite direction. This is also the opinion of Rutherford. So Anderson did not convince Majorana. However, in 1933 there were experiments by Blackett and Occhialini, cloud chamber controlled by Geiger counters, and then there is no doubt that there are deposits and so on. So in a famous letter to Emilio Segret, May 22, 1933, Majorana communicated the season news that in Leipzig the direct theory of negative electrons is gaining credit and Heisenberg is seriously involved. Yes. So this is a letter to Segret. This is a famous letter also for other reason. There is novità di stagione, si crede negli elettroni negativi. With a great emotion I present this because this is not Xerox which does exist. This is a picture which we took from the original, so we could see the original. Okay, so he did not find necessary to publish the paper. So the positron is a triumph for Dirac theory, Nobel Prize. And so Majorana arrives to the symmetric. He's very, very, very smart to recuperate the situation. So essentially he gives the interpretation in terms of quantum fields. There are no non-negative energy states. And it is modern electrodynamics in a sense. Dirac field coupled. Clearly, the results were obtained many years before, but it is only in 1937 that the paper appears. There are four pages of the original manuscript in the Majorana archive in Pisa. They are identical to the published version. Only a small part. Where are the other pages? So this is one of the surviving pages. It is, of course, a very well-known paper. There are two essential ingredients. So first of all, relativistic wave equation can have a consistent physical interpretation on the frame of quantum field theory. And also he makes there is no place for the Dirac C. He has this choice of the Dirac matrices so that it becomes completely symmetric. And there is a witness, Giancarlo Vick, says that Majorana many, many years before did the same for the Klein-Gordon equation. So to have a quantum field theory interpretation of the Klein-Gordon equation. Then there is, of course, the use of the Majorana representation for the Dirac matrices. Of course, the physical theory is invariant with respect to the choice of the. But Majorana gives a representation which the symmetry is clear. And he, in one parenthesis, tells us that new description for neutral particles, neutron and the neutrino. Where particle and antiparticle, of course, the neutron is excluded magnetic momentum. Okay, so if Majorana neutrino does exist, it will have some consequences and so on. Neutrino is Italian name, small neutral particle. Okay. Only I say one thing about the timing of the paper. Majorana did not have any position in the Via Panisperna building. He had the Libera Docenza in 1932, so he could give a course. He was eager to give a course, so he gave programs, but he could not really. So he went to Leipzig in 1933. Then he did not publish any paper. Then there was this competition for a chair in theoretical physics in Palermo. The competition is called by official announcement of the minister. Before the announcement, Majorana did not have the scientific titles to participate because he did not publish for 3 or 4 years. But in the interval between the official announcement of the minister and the deadline for application, he published the paper. So it is perfect timing. If it was done on purpose, maybe Majorana was very, very smart, more than we think. Should he have published before, then maybe Segre was in Palermo, Majorana could have been the winner, maybe the official announcement would never appear. So, official announcement appear. In fact, we know that Majorana took some contacts with Giancarlo Vick, and Giancarlo Vick did agree to go to Palermo. So, the issuing of the competition, Majorana could not participate. In the interval, you see, April, March is the call, and March is the official call. March 15, we see that the preprint is April. June 15 is the deadline. And so everything was, but Majorana did not win because we know that under suggestion of the committee, the minister decided to let him be a full professor in Naples. So he never went to Palermo, but Giancarlo Vick went to Palermo. Okay, that's.
Played an important role in the thinking of Majorana. What was his attitude towards parity violation?
At the time, so in the part of the paper which is crossed, he considered time reversal invariance. Because at the beginning he was trying to use only real wave functions. So, of course, wave functions in any case must be complex. In all papers of Majorana, there is exploitation of symmetry in the papers in atomic physics, molecular physics. But for parity, I think it was too early to speak.
You mentioned that there is only one line in the Majorana paper
Yes.
concerning neutrino, but in fact, Racah published a few weeks later something in which the neutrino was explicitly mentioned. So can you comment on this?
No. The Majorana mentioned he said I give a new theory for neutral particles, which could be applied to neutron or hypothetical neutrino. Racah published the paper on Nuovo Cimento, making a criticism. The paper was published after the deadline, before the committee would meet, so it's not considered. But Racah paper is completely right. So he said neutron cannot be considered, and for the neutrino, he said that then there should be modification of Fermi theory and so on. So there was a lively discussion. It is also important to remark then that when the committee asked the minister to make Majorana full professor in some other university of the kingdom outside of the present competition, because they said we hesitate to follow the rules. The rules were a comparison among the candidates, and Majorana is so strong that we hesitate to make a comparison. So they asked the minister to make Majorana professor ordinario, full professor in some university of the kingdom. They had to give a motivation, and of course this paper was a strong motivation, but only for the symmetrical theory and for the fact that there was no There was no Dirac C in the theory. The committee did not mention the idea of Majorana, of the neutrino, of course. So it clearly, I mean, he made a great contribution to see that neutral one-half neutral particles, which are their own antiparticle, are possible. And then there has been a big development. But I would like also to say that even the neutron, which was criticized by Racah, there is some intervention of Bruno Pontecorvo. He says, in this paper, in the paper of Majorana, there is also the idea of oscillations neutron, anti-neutron, because at the great unification, then the great unification, the neutron can be looked at as a Majorana particle. Bruno Pontecorvo is very smart. Let me make a joke, he says. I will give you the right citation, so that at the end.
Il marche pas.
Okay.
Why he didn't publish any paper between, maybe you said it, but I didn't get it, maybe I misunderstood. He didn't publish any paper between 1933 and 1936?
Yes, there was the loss of the father, a great delusion, and the great, the main hit is that he wanted to give the free course at the university and never did. But he had the results, and the timing of the results was that it was forbidden for him to publish the year before. Otherwise, he would not have had any kind of chance. Only the national competition was his only chance. In any case, Majorana personality is very, very complicated. It's completely different from what is understood. He was not shy. I would say he was quite arrogant, very aggressive. Criticism, great inquisitor. The criticism was terrible against the professors, against Heisenberg, against Fermi. He even says that Bohr rimbambito, which is a terrible Italian word, which becomes, he had a regression to the period as infant. To Bohr, I mean to say, and he was going to visit Bohr. Bohr greeted him because he was trying to find the institute which is near the Carlsberg plant, and Majorana did not find the institute. Bohr arrived with the bicycle and found Majorana there and so on. But he made a terrible criticism against Bohr. And even in the paper here, Symmetrical Theory of Electron and Positron, there is, of course, strong criticism against Dirac. You can imagine, Dirac won the Nobel Prize in 1933, and you can. But if you look carefully, from a historical point of view, there was even strong criticism against Heisenberg and Jordan, because Heisenberg and Jordan, in a paper at the end of the 20s, they made a second quantization of Dirac field without understanding that there was the positron there. Because the proper second quantization of the Dirac field gives the positron. You have to, the field, the quantum field is one part creation of a particle, the other is destruction of the antiparticle. So if you look at the Heisenberg-Jordan paper, 29, 30, I don't remember exactly the date, you see that it is not completely right.
You see, John Bell used to say the reason Dirac came up with this equation was because he thought the Klein-Gordon equation, which was relativistic, was inconsistent, you know, because it had negative energy solutions. Yes. And so he did, because at that time they did not associate that to antiparticles. I mean, we have charged mesons, and yes, the Klein-Gordon would be valid, and then the other ones would be negative, and because yes, of that. And so that's why Dirac thought that the only way you can have a relativistic maybe is to have a linear equation.
Yes.
So I mean, Dirac equation is the simplest equation you can teach yes. your students in two dimensions. It's absolutely the simplest thing you can do, yes. right? I mean, you just have two dimensions and teach them in 1 hour. Is all that, but and then this question of whole, you know, and I think it was what happened is that there were Pauli was very much against it, Heisenberg was very much against it, and Pauli came back in these his letters, which I said there are 8,000 pages of letters of Pauli, and then they all over and over and over again he was against that. In particle physics, we are very arrogant to holes. I remember Weinberg was in Lund giving a talk, and he said, this is just the most stupid idea, the holes. But on the other hand, we have to remember that these holes are extremely useful in solid-state physics. So you see, you have to be a little bit careful when you criticize the theory. You have to think of what you mean by your vacuum state. What is your vacuum state? And so what is hole there, you know? Because I think these for solid state people would not be able to live without the holes. Yes. So I think it's interesting.
Okay.
Oh no, of course, you're completely right. I mean, Dirac's great idea was to, Schrödinger equation is linear in the time derivative. So momentum should appear linear in the equation. So then you have a multiple.
Let's go again.